Here we have the series k equals 0 to infinity of negative 1 to the k times 3. So if we write out some of the terms of the series, the first term is negative 1 to the 0 times 3, so it's 1 times 3. The second term is negative 1 to the first, that's negative 1 times 3, so now we subtract 3. And then we have negative 1 squared, so it's positive 1 times 3, and so on. So we see that our series is alternating. If we write out some of the partial sums, the first partial sum is going to be 3 minus 3, which is 0. The second partial sum is 3 minus 3 plus 3, so that's 3. The third partial sum is 3 minus 3 plus 3 minus 3, so that's 0. So what we're noticing is that the limit as n goes to infinity of S sub n, our sequence of partial sums, does not exist. And so our series is going to diverge. We could also justify this using the divergence test. The limit as k goes to infinity of a sub k is the limit as k goes to infinity of negative 1 to the k times 3, and this does not equal 0. So by the divergence test, our series will diverge. Here we have the alternating series k equals 0 to infinity of negative 2/3 to the k. So we can rewrite this as the series from k equals 0 to infinity, negative 1 to the k times 2/3 to the k. So now we have an alternating series with our a sub k equals 2/3 to the k. So that means that when we're using our alternating series test, our function f of x equals 2/3 to the x, and the derivative of f of x is 2/3 to the x times the natural log of 2/3. We now use our sign chart to determine if our derivative is always negative, and this has no zero values or values that aren't in the domain. So we only have one sign the entire time. And if we test a value like 0, we get 1 times the natural log of 2/3, and that is negative. So our derivative is always negative, which means that f of x is decreasing. So that means that a sub k is non-increasing. For our second condition, we need to check that the limit as k goes to infinity of a sub k, which is 2/3 to the k, equals 0. And this is true. So we've satisfied condition 2. So this was condition 1, and this was condition 2. So therefore, by the alternating series test, our series k equals 0 to infinity of negative 2/3 to the k converges. Here we have the series k equals 1 to infinity of negative 1 to the k plus 1 times k plus 3 divided by k plus 2. So this is an alternating series, and our a sub k equals k plus 3 divided by k plus 2. So that if we write this as a function, f of x equals x plus 3 divided by x plus 2, when we take the derivative, we get the f prime of x equals x plus 2 minus the quantity x plus 3 divided by the quantity x plus 2 squared. And this simplifies to negative 1 over the quantity x plus 2 squared. So when we draw our sine chart for our derivative, we have a 0 at negative 2, so we need to test points on both sides. So if we test something bigger than negative 2, like 0, we're going to get a negative over a positive, so it's negative. If we test something less than negative 2, like negative 3, we're still getting a negative over a positive, so that's negative. So this means that f is decreasing on the interval 1 to infinity, and we care about this interval because k starts at 1. So that means that a sub k is non-increasing for k equals 1, 2, 3, etc. So that's our first condition. We've satisfied that. Now we need to check our second condition. So if we find the limit as k goes to infinity of a sub k, that's the limit as k goes to infinity of k plus 3 over k plus 2. But this equals 1, does not equal 0, so we can't use the alternating series test. However, we can use the divergence test with our original series. If we take the limit as k goes to infinity of negative 1 to the k plus 1 times k plus 3 over k plus 2, since this part doesn't equal 0, multiplying by negative 1 and 1 won't allow this limit to equal 0 either. So this limit will also not equal 0. So by the divergence test, this series diverges. Here we have the series k equals 1 to infinity of cosine of k times pi divided by e to the k. So first, let's convince ourselves that this is in fact an alternating series. Cosine of k times pi is going to equal negative 1 to the k for k equals 1, 2, 3, etc. Because, for example, if we found cosine of pi, that's negative 1. If we find cosine of 2 pi, that equals 1. If we find cosine of 3 pi, that's negative 1. So you can also think about this with the unit circle. Remember, cosine is the x value. So at pi, we're over here at negative 1. Then at 2 pi, we're at 1, 3 pi, we're back at negative 1, and so on, going around our unit circle. So we can rewrite this as the series k equals 1 to infinity of negative 1 to the k over e to the k. So this is an alternating series with a sub k equals 1 over e to the k. First, we need to make sure that a sub k is non-increasing. So if we find f of x equals 1 over e to the x, and if we can rewrite this as e to the negative x, so f prime of x equals negative e to the negative x. So drawing our number line with f prime, there's no values that aren't in our domain and no zeros for f prime. So we're going to be the same sign the entire time. So we plug in something, we can plug in 0. So we would get a negative number. So f is decreasing. So a sub k is non-increasing. So this satisfies condition 1. So next we need to check if the limit as k goes to infinity of 1 over e to the k equals 0, which it does, so that satisfies condition 2. So by the alternating series test, our series converges. We have the series k equals 1 to infinity of negative 1 to the k plus 1 times k squared, all divided by e to the k. So this is an alternating series with a sub k equals k squared over e to the k. So here we have the f of x equals x squared divided by e to the x, or we could rewrite this as x squared times e to the negative x. So when we take the derivative, we get the f prime of x equals 2x e to the negative x minus x squared times e to the negative x, which is x e to the negative x times 2 minus x. So here we have zeros at 0 and 2. So checking our intervals, if we check negative 1, so if we check negative 1, we're going to have a negative times a positive, which is negative. If we check something between 0 and 2, like 1, we're going to get a positive times a positive. If we check something greater than 2, such as 3, we'll get a positive times a negative. So this set tells us that f of x is decreasing only on 2 to infinity. And that doesn't match with k equals 1, where we're starting. But this does tell us that a sub k is non-increasing on the interval 3 to infinity. So if instead we considered the series k equals 3 to infinity of negative 1 to the k plus 1 times k squared over e to the k. So if we left off the first two terms, then we would be satisfying condition 1. We could then look at the limit as k goes to infinity of k squared divided by e to the k, and that equals 0, so we're satisfying condition 2. So by the alternating series test, we have that the series k equals 3 to infinity of negative 1 to the k plus 1 times k squared divided by e to the k converges. So that tells us that the series k equals 1 to infinity of negative 1 to the k plus 1 times k squared divided by e to the k will also converge because we are only adding on the first two terms. We're only adding on the term k equals 1, so that would be 1 divided by e minus 4 divided by e squared. So these two terms alone won't make our series diverge. If we know that the series from k equals 1 to infinity of negative 1 to the k plus 1 divided by k equals natural log of 2, we want to know how many terms of the sequence are needed to approximate the natural log of 2 to within 10 to the negative 12. So we have an alternating series with a sub k equals 1 divided by k. So we want a sub n plus 1 to be less than or equal to 10 to the negative 12th so that we would have our remainder as less than or equal to a sub n plus 1 is less than or equal to 10 to the negative 12th. So since we want a sub n plus 1 to be less than or equal to 10 to the negative 12th, so the n plus first term is 1 divided by n plus 1, and we want that to be less than or equal to 1 divided by 10 to the 12th. So that means that n plus 1 is greater than or equal to 10 to the 12th. So that means that n is greater than or equal to 10 to the 12th minus 1. So that means it takes 10 to the 12th minus 1 terms. Here we have the series k equals 1 to infinity of negative 4 to the k divided by k factorial, and that equals e to the negative 4th minus 1. And we want to know how many terms of the sequence are needed to approximate e to the negative 4th minus 1 to within 10 to the negative 12th. So we have an alternating series with a sub k equals 4 to the k divided by k factorial, and this is non-increasing for k is greater than or equal to 4, and the limit as k goes to infinity of a sub k equals 0. So we want a sub n plus 1 to be less than or equal to 10 to the negative 12th, so that we have our remainder is less than or equal to a sub n plus 1 is less than or equal to 10 to the negative 12th. So we have 4 to the n plus 1 divided by n plus 1 factorial is less than or equal to 1 over 10 to the 12th. Or we could write this as 10 to the 12th is less than or equal to n plus 1 factorial times 1 divided by 4 to the n plus 1. So we look at this and we know that we want to solve for n, but that seems kind of difficult. So we're going to guess some values. So let's say we guess that n plus 1 is 27. So if we do 4 to the 27th divided by 27 factorial, we'll find this is greater than 10 to the negative 12th. So if we go larger and we try 4 to the 28th divided by 28 factorial, this is less than 10 to the negative 12th. So that means that n plus 1 has to be greater than or equal to 28, so n must be greater than or equal to 27. So 27 terms are needed.